What's happening, folks? Welcome back to Celtic Fans TV. It's time for the starting 11 prediction for tomorrow's game away at St Mirren. We're obviously looking to avenge last month's 2-1 defeat at home against them, and we're looking for our third win on the spin, which hasn't happened this calendar year as of yet. Before we get to tonight's video, I want to tell you about a new feature that we've got coming up. It should hopefully be ready in time for this weekend's games. I'm not going to tell you what it is, but it is something different. It's something interactive. It's going to hopefully be something that you guys are watching and enjoy. I think it's something, as I say, totally different. It will give a different dynamic. It's a new feature, a new bit of content. So stay tuned for that. And before we get to the team, tonight's video is brought to you by OneFootball, the best football app on the planet. You can get goal alerts from leagues around the world, pre-match stats, lineup notifications as soon as the teams are announced on match days, league tables. You can create widgets for your home screen so you can keep tabs on Celtic's next fixture, who it's against, what the kickoff time is, and you can get all the Celtic-related news as soon as it breaks as well. You can download the app by clicking the link in the description of this video. As I keep saying, it's a brilliant way for you to support the channel, so if you haven't downloaded it already, please click the link below and let me know what you think. St Mirren come into this one sitting sixth in the table. They're on 32 points in their two games since they played us at Celtic Park and beat us. They obviously went on to lose the next game, predictably. That's always what happens. But they did beat Kilmarnock at the weekend, so they've had one win and one defeat since we last faced them. I think it's obvious for the game at Celtic Park that we can't underestimate them. I thought they played well that day. We were obviously very, very poor, but some men had a game plan. They were organised, they defended well, and they attacked us as well. They scored two goals, and to be fair, they probably deserved their victory, and that's why we have to play properly. We have to play at a high level, because we didn't do that the last time. And St Mirren have shown that if we don't turn up, then they can shock us. So we've got to play much better. I listened to Callum McGregor's press conference today, and Callum McGregor, like most players, he's underperformed at times this season. But I think in his interviews and his press conferences, he's been brutally honest at times, and you can tell that he cares. There's obviously not a lot for the players to play for, players that are used to winning things. They don't have a lot to compete for in these games that are remaining, but they're still playing for Celtic, and they've got to bring us a high level. And as I say, looking for three wins on the spin, we've just got to try and put together as many wins as possible. In terms of the team, before I came on to do the video, the news broke that Albin Ayeti won't serve a ban for that penalty against Kilmarnock. Rightly so, we talked about it last week. I think it was a bit of a scandalous decision to try and ban him for it. There was clear contact there. That's not what a dive is. That's not simulation. So it's good that he's fit and available for this game. I think we could see an unchanged team. That's something we've not seen enough of this season for the most part. I think in goals, Scott Bain will obviously keep his place. I think he was at fault for the goal. I know it takes a deflection at the weekend, but I think it shouldn't loop over him. He should be able to get his hands to it. He's close enough to his goal line. It's almost like he doesn't know the size of his goals, but I think he'll keep his place. At right back, John Joe Kenny will play there. I think another relatively impressive performance. Steady at the weekend. He'll be tested as we go through. We can't judge him yet, but I think he's been all right so far. Centre half, Welsh and Ayer. No reason to drop Stephen Welsh. I think he's done really well since he's came into the team. Got a brilliant headed goal at the weekend, and this experience will do him the world of good. At left back, Greg Taylor. I think he'll start again. We've seen Laxalt come off the bench in the last two games now, I think it is. But I think Taylor's just done enough to keep his place there. And off the back of two wins, I don't think there's going to be drastic changes to the team. In midfield, I'd expect us to go with a diamond again. That'll be Scott Brown at the base of it. Neil Lennon's obviously saying today that Soros crashed his car on the way into training in the snow. So I think he's all right, but I don't think he's going to start the game tomorrow. And if you remember the last time we played St Mirren, when they beat us, Soros was playing there in midfield. So that'll be as good a reason as any to start Scott Brown. Callum McGregor will obviously be there on the left-hand side of the diamond. On the right-hand side, I think David Turnbull is going to have to play there again. The manager said Christie's fit. Christie's fit and available. I don't know if he was out 3 or 4 days ago with an ankle injury, if he's going to come straight back into the starting 11. So I'm just going to put Turnbull on the sort of right-hand side of the diamond. And I'm going to say Tom Rogic will keep his place in the 10. We could see Elyounoussi come in there. I think Rogic at the weekend was bright in spells. You know what you're going to get from him. His footwork, brilliant at times. He did tire as the game went on. The goalkeeper, Liam Kelly, denied him a great goal, actually. He cut inside in his left foot. Really, really powerful strike, headed for the top corner, and Kelly saved it. Could have had a goal on another day. I said that I think his best days at Celtic are behind him, because he's just been here for so long. I know that he's 28 years old. I just think he was nearly out the door in the summer, and he's never been able to nail down a consistent starting place for 2-3 years now. So I don't know if we'll ever see him get back to those invincible season levels, but you never know, under a new manager he could possibly rejuvenate him. I'm just going to go with him in the 10 for tomorrow. And then up top, Edouard and Ayeti. Edouard playing really well now, 17 goals this season for a player that's massively underperformed in spells. That shows you what he could have done if he was in top form this season. There's no doubt he'd be approaching 30 if he was anywhere near the form that we know he can show for most of this season. And Albin Ayeti, maybe not as effective as he was against Kilmarnock at the weekend, and that he didn't get a goal. I think some of his play was fine. He didn't really get too many chances. That one that he blazed over the bar, first time in his left foot, he just missed Taylor's cross that would surely have been a tap-in. But the games are going to do him the world of good. He's got to get his fitness up. He's got to get his match sharpness to a place where he can really be considered as a long-term starter. And hopefully his partnership with Edouard can develop in these games they're playing together. We know Edouard and Griffiths have been brilliant together. I think Edouard's at a level, when he's playing well, he's so easy to play with for a strike partner. And I think he can raise the level of whoever it is that's up there beside him, because his link-up play is so good. So I expect to see Ayeti start again. That'll do him the world of good. That would be an unchanged team for the weekend. And again, that would help us, because that sort of consistency and starting lineup is something we haven't seen enough this season. And as I keep saying, we've just got to go and try and finish the season in a positive way. Still a lot of talk, obviously, in social media about the New Year review. I'm resigned to the fact that we're not going to hear anything. The manager will be in place to the end of the season, regardless what happens. We could have, this is obviously the stadium where we had Tony Mowbray's Tony Mowbray moment. We could have one of them tomorrow, and I think the manager would still be here after it. But it does look like the cogs are starting to turn for the change that we want to see at the club. It's just a pity that they didn't change the manager earlier this season and we could still be in with a fight. Because you see the Rangers game at the weekend, I don't think Rangers have been anywhere near top form in the last 3 or 4 weeks. They have still been grinding out wins. Not at the weekend, but most of the time they've been grinding out wins. If we were in any sort of touching distance to them, maybe the pressure would be telling. And maybe we'd be able to actually close the gap to the point where you think the title race was still alive. But because the board decided not to change the manager back in November, and then we had the whole disaster that was January, we found ourselves in a situation where it honestly doesn't matter what Rangers' results are now or how poor they are. We can't affect the title race in any way. And that's a damn indictment of where we've been this season. But that's the team I think we'll go with tomorrow. And we'll try and get another win. And we'll try and talk about it as positively as we can in this season of all seasons. Like the video, comment your own thoughts below. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. We'll see you tomorrow for all the live full-time reaction straight after the game. Cheers.